Okay, now we're going to install new radius rod bushes. That's the radius rod there. Might be able to see it underneath there. That's the radius rod bushes. And I'm going to do it now because the radiator's removed. I'm doing the timing belt and water pump and alternator. So there's the radius rod there and the bushes there. So what I think I'll do is undo this nut here and then undo the two bolts back there, and then work on it from there, I think. So there, with a bit of light, we can see the reason why I'm replacing these bushes. And the rod, that's the one behind that runs there. Sorry, it's the front. The front rod runs to there with two bolts. From what I can gather, the radius rod absorbs any impact from the swing arm there. So we can see the swing arm's a fairly robust part of the suspension, and it runs to the wheel there. But it really just absorbs anything to the rear and the front, so it's a bit like a stabilizer, so the bushings don't wear out there. I think it's this nut here that connects on the inner part of the suspension. Okay, this is what I'm doing so far. I've got a 24 millimeter socket that's on the nut there. I've got some penetrating oil on the end. I'm able to fit that on there. The car is raised, but only so I can get the travel to undo the nut. Okay. I do have a piece of pipe that slips on the end there. Okay, and I'm able to push that down and get a bit of a turn out of it at this stage. Okay, at this stage, the car is up on blocks. I've also got the jack stand there, and the rear wheels are chocked on either side. Okay, we'll give it a safety test. Okay, so I'm just rocking the car back and forth just to make sure that it'll hold before I work underneath. Okay, so let's get to it. Okay, we've got our washer, this spacer or a cone. I'm not sure if that's turned around the wrong way or not. I think that's supposed to be the other way around. So a washer, this cone, two rubber bushings, another cone. And on this side we've got a cone, seems to be the right way turned around possibly. And the one at the back here. And two rubber spacers or absorbers, and two absorbers here. Now I'll try and get this assembly off and the two nuts there. And now where are we? Those there. I'll try and get that removed. Okay, well I can't get this rubber piece off because it's hitting right up there at the back. where are we? That point there. So that won't pass through there. So I'm going to have to get the nuts off now and bring the whole assembly back. Okay, so the that end is off. And so now it should just slip out. And there we have it. So that's the rubber bushing that that went on there. And again, funnily enough, this was dished out. I've got a good idea to put it back properly. So anyway. I'm not really sure why you'd need grease. I am going to put these on with the cup facing the rubber. So far as I know, this isn't a moving part, but they've supplied the grease, and so I suppose it's something like this. I'm guessing it'll go on, and of course this is a different design to the original. It's also much smaller, so yeah, well, it is what it is, and it was the only kit, so okay, well, back on it goes. Okay, so I'll put some of that bushing grease on the metal parts. They were fairly rusted, so okay, I'll go ahead and install this metal rod now. Okay, so that's the packet that the bushings came in. Okay, I've backed this nut off about 5 millimeters. I used this adjustable wrench, bit of penetrating oil. I put it in a vise, and it was quite easy to turn. Okay, the stabilizer bar's on. I did install it with the dish toward the rubber there, because this dish and this dish is also, it's scooped in or bent in toward the rubber. So this is now bent in, that's bent in, and so it's just a matter of putting the rubber on there. Actually, I see why they've designed it this way, because now we see we can get the rubber on without having to thread the rod through. So yeah, that's a bit of a bonus if that's why they've changed the design for efficiency. Then it might be a superior design. Okay, so we can see the way that nut went on. So if that will just thread on there, then that's my ticket and that's job done. So now we just tighten up this bolt and that bolt there. When the car's up on blocks, and also when it's down, just to get it tight. So that's pretty self-explanatory. So we'll call that job done. You see, that's the item I bought, and they're clearly the same as the originals, but not the ones I was sent. The bushings I was sent are these type here. That's for like a Nissan, apparently. So I can see here the same on those two. Okay, with these radius rod bushes, this is a non-standard part. However, it could be a better design. And I contacted the people that sold these bushes to me, and they did say that it does fit. However, I can see that there's a problem here, and that is that this cup here, or this wider edge, won't accommodate this cup. So what I have to do is, the correct way would be for this to face this dish and for this smaller area to go into that cup, because you can see that edge there is too wide, and that's the original rubbers. And we can see that the left side would accommodate this dish, but this certainly wouldn't fit in the cup, and that's what's caused this damage here. So I've got the bolts off, and I'll just turn this one around, and so that would mean that this one, this smaller area there, would go in that way, and then that sits in the dish properly, and that'll sit in the cup here. Okay, so that's what I'm looking for, that design there. Okay, so that's it, they're both done. The wide side is on the dish, and the dish is pointing inwards, and now on the other side is done as well. How I got this nut here is going to be done up pretty well if it's 27 years old. So what I did on this side, I found that I had to get the socket on an extension. I put that on, and I needed it out here for it to clear. And I brought the pipe again right up to the end there. That's slid off. That's okay. I'm just going to knock back that dowel there to fit in there. So it won't come out. But anyway, yeah, that's done. To get the room, you'll need under the front to work the bar and get all the right amount of torque and pressures. You're going to have to raise the car up a fair way, okay? But with me, it's always on blocks. So, and again, the back wheel's chocked, so that's job done for the radius rod bushes. So, yep, she should be sitting pretty. Amazing how this part here is not straight. It should be on more of an angle like that to match the angle from there, the angle of the radius rod arm. But tilted too far back. But anyway, nothing's perfect. No one's perfect. So, another thing I found that with these bushes, that I just tightened the front nut up with the radius rod arm, and then I tightened the back up to it, so there's enough pressure on that. So, you know, that's job done with the radius rod arms.